Advanced Studio Classroom is on the air. Welcome to the month of August, and our first lesson will be a lifestyle one, so stay tuned. We're glad that you're here with us today listening, and we're also glad to have some of our editors in the studio with us as our panelists. We have our editor of the Studio Classroom magazine, Linda Ludwig.
Thank you. It's so nice to be here. I always enjoy being on Advanced Studio Classroom.
Well, it's always good to have you. And then we have another Linda. How come we have two Lindas today?
It's called Lindas Unite.
Yes, that's right. Linda Jung. But you also work on all of the magazines, don't you?
Yeah, I do something with each of the magazines, so it keeps it interesting.
So we can ask you some questions, and you can give some content, and we can talk about a lifestyle. And we're going to talk about several kinds of lifestyles the next few days, aren't we, Linda?
Right, we are. And our first one... Actually, you could speak to this, Doris. Our first one is, you know, age is just a number, right?
Yes, that's true. I knew we were going to get into that, but you don't have to start right off. But we're going to talk about an inspiring senior. Now, seniors could be somebody in senior high school or senior in age. Senior means someone who has been doing it for a while, right?
Yeah, it means older.
Older? It means older, right?
Let's just say that.
But, you know, it's inspiring if you see people who are older and still enjoy life, isn't
it? Exactly.
It certainly is. And I think you enjoy life. I think you're a good inspiration to everybody that you're around.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that we need to remember that as long as there's life, there's supposed to be hope and living and fun. So enjoy it. But we're going to talk about that article for the first day. And then the second day, we'll talk about a calming ritual. And what are we going to talk about the third day?
A serious warning.
Wow, so that's 3 days ahead. So are you going to stay with me for these 3 days?
I will.
That's good.
Okay.
All right.
I'm there.
All right. So let's find out about this because we're going to start out for the inspiring senior in California. And we're going to read about it first. So open your magazines now and we'll look at page 10.
Enhancing your lifestyle. Learn more about an inspiring senior, a calming ritual, and a serious warning. Surf City Half Marathon. At 90, she's celebrating the pure joy of racing. Dorothy Joy walked her first Surf City Half Marathon in Huntington Beach, California, at age 75. On Sunday, February 5th, at 90, she walked her last, or so she says. Surrounded by four generations of family and several longtime friends, Joy celebrated her recent birthday the way she has for a decade plus, by walking 13.1 miles. "I've done 63 5K races," said Joy, a California resident. "One 10K, 53 halves, and 10 relays. Joy's active lifestyle inspires family members and strangers alike, said daughter Jenny Dean. Mobile family gatherings. Dean, one of three daughters, and Mandy Marangakis, one of four grandchildren, walk with Joy for the quality time together race days afford. Marangakis, the antithesis of a morning person, she joked, has braved dawn the past few years and learned about her grandparents' relationship as a result. Recently, Marangakis's teenage daughter, Ashley, one of 10 great-grandchildren, joined the mobile family gathering. "We talk about all kinds of family history out there," said Joy, who'll continue to walk competitively, but only shorter races.
So we see here that we're in Surf City. And Surf City is actually in California at Huntington Beach. And, you know, they have marathons all over the world, and this is just one of the places that they are holding another marathon. This is a half marathon. So, Linda, have you – I know you bike, but have you ever run?
I only run during our Let's Run.
We just ran.
Yeah. I have participated, but I haven't done any marathons or half marathons. And a marathon, a full marathon, is 26 miles. Which is a really long way. So that's a half marathon would be half of that.
What is a marathon, though?
A marathon is something that you just keep on doing.
Going on and on, never stop.
It seems like it. So a marathon, we usually use this word when we're talking about a race, but you can also use it in other situations as well, like maybe – I think sometimes some TV programs want to raise money, like public broadcasting or public television, and they have like what's called a marathon call-in. Mm-hmm. So people can call in and pledge money. So it has that feeling of continuance.
Right. We usually call those telethons. So it's taking off the word
marathon.
That it's for goes on for a long time.
Until they get their goal, until they reach the goal. They usually have a goal on it, right? Well, you notice now that this lady is 90 years old. Now, that's pretty old, isn't it?
Sounds old to me, Doris.
Sounds old to me.
In 5 days, you're going to be older than that.
Well, that's true. But, you know, you can still have fun at 90, and she's celebrating the pure joy of racing. So one thing is, every year, no matter how old you are, keep celebrating things. And celebrating makes life more exciting, doesn't it?
Right. And what we see here that actually her birthday, she actually ran this. She didn't run it. She walked this marathon last February. So now she is 91.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And she is celebrating life. You know, you can't keep a good woman down.
That's true.
And she's a very good example of it. I love the name of her team. The name of her team is called Team Joy. And Walk of Ages, if you look at the bottom of page 10, you can see the back of her T-shirt that she wears.
Right.
And I think her whole purpose is to inspire people.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
That's what she says. And, you know, I like the pictures down here of all of these people. And she says, I'm 90, but I don't really feel like it. And I know how she feels because I don't feel like it either. So she doesn't feel like it, but it hasn't sunk in. And when something sinks in, that means you don't even know that. How can I really be? And she hasn't figured out that she's really 90, right?
Yeah. I think it is true that age is a state of mind, kind of, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. I think so, right. Because she says, wow, am I really 90? You could say that. Am I really 60? Am I really 70? Mm-hmm. You could say that every one of those 10-year guidepost things, couldn't you?
Well, when you turned 90, you said this.
I said that, yeah. Because you don't feel any different.
Right. I think we don't mind being the age. We just mind saying it because of the reaction from other people.
Oh, really? Oh, my goodness. Please sit down.
At least you get a seat that way.
Well, that's true sometimes, right? But, you know, it is true that as long as you feel good, you should do things you can do.
Right.
Whatever age. But she said that, she was going to walk her last one. She said, well, this is my last one.
Right. We don't know for sure if this is going to be her last one.
I always say this is my last one, too. My last Mother's Day, my last, you know, but who knows?
Exactly.
Nobody really knows. Just keep celebrating, right?
Well,
right.
What I like is that she has included her entire family. You know, it's a way of including them in her lifestyle. And here she is walking with 4 generations of her family.
Right.
Which is pretty impressive.
Mm-hmm. Well, it is. I should say so.
So she must be her generation and then her daughter's generation and her granddaughter's generation and her great-granddaughter's generation.
That's quite a bit. And they talk about the races here. And she's done so many. I can't believe she's done 63, 5K. Now, what are 5K? 5 kilometer, right?
That's exactly, about 2.5 miles, isn't it?
She's done 63 of those.
Yeah.
Can you imagine?
No. Not really.
And not only that, she's also done a 10K.
Then that's even worse. That's longer, right?
Yeah, that's double.
But only one of 53 those. Half marathons. Okay, that is 53, and that is 13.1 miles, or 13 miles, right?
Mm-hmm.
She's done 53 of them.
Yeah, that's impressive. Wow.
And then we have the word relay here. She's also done 10 relays.
Right, and a relay is when there's more than one person involved, and you pass a baton, like a
stick.
Yeah. To the next
you
person.
Go through
so you race
one,
together.
Yeah. To somebody else.
Mm-hmm. Right. Usually there are several people on a team, right?
Yeah.
I mean, in the Olympics, I've seen there are four people mm-hmm. usually on mm-hmm. a relay team.
Right.
She's done more than most people I've ever heard of, right?
Right. And that's called a relay.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, because she does have this active lifestyle, well, it inspires your family because they can say, well, look at grandma, she's still doing it.
Mm-hmm. Or great-grandma.
Great-grandma.
And so they have no excuse.
No excuse. If I can do it, you can do it, see?
But I think it's kind of cool that it's not only her family members, but also strangers.
That's
because
true.
How many people do you meet on a marathon? You know, hundreds of people run these.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I'm probably 100% accurate when I say she's the oldest person
she's
walking or running this.
I'm sure she is, right. And her daughter, Jenny Dean, she's one of the three daughters. And then she has, how many, four grandchildren? They walk
right.
with her.
Right.
So they all kind of walk together. It's a family time. And I've seen that when we have our little walking marathons here, too. Mm-hmm. And the families come together. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, they come all together. And it's really fun for all of them, for the parents and children.
The little kids and, together. Yeah, sometimes the parents. And I've seen three generations.
Right.
Sometimes.
I've seen parents running also with their kids, even in strollers at our Let's Run.
Right.
So, yeah, they've made it a real family affair.
So they can say, you know, that it is a good time to be together. And when we enjoy being with our family, what do we call that sometimes? Quality time?
Yeah.
Right.
We do.
That's
meaningful time together.
Meaningful time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you can spend a lot of time together, but if you don't do anything or talk to each other mm-hmm. or enjoy each other, it's not really quality time.
Right. And, yeah, it doesn't mean that you have to go out and run to do this. Different families do different things for mm-hmm. family time. Our family enjoys playing board games together.
Mm-hmm. And that's quality time.
Right. And, you can sit and talk about a lot of things. You're not just staring at the board, just playing your game.
That's true.
You know, it gives you opportunity to engage in discussion.
Mm-hmm. Or even cooking together, doing something together
right?
that allows mm-hmm. you to bond.
Singing in a choir together, mm-hmm. the family.
I think that we're in this technology age, and, you know, oftentimes when you see a family...
they're all on their devices.
Right. I was thinking that because my mm-hmm. son recently came to visit, and I looked up the other day when he was here, and I was like, we're all on our devices.
We're all looking at them, right? But still, you had quality time just being together looking at your devices,
right.
even, right? You know. But it says here, though, in the second column here that they have quality time together that race days afford. This word afford is kind of different usage here.
Right. They're not buying this time, right? It's when you use afford in this way, it means that race days offer them or give them.
Yeah.
So the race days are just providing them the time and the place where they can be together.
Right. It allows them to have this quality time together.
That's true.
Yes.
Well, do all the grandchildren really like to do this, you think? I mean, get up early and everything.
It's probably not what they really want to do, especially if they are not morning people and they have to wake up maybe at 5 a.m. for
right.
a race.
That's true.
Well, they give the example of one of the grandkids that does this, and it says that she is the antithesis of a morning person, which means she's the opposite.
Mm.
And if she's a teenager, if this is a teenager... Yeah, mm-hmm. definitely not wanting to get up at 5 a.m.
But she did it.
Yeah. And it says I like the way they say this. She is brave dawn. So dawn, we know, is sunrise mm-hmm. or the beginning of the day. And so she's brave dawn means.
She very boldly does it. Okay, I'm going to get up for grandma.
She hasn't been afraid.
Right. She braved it. Brave through something means that you do it. Even though you don't necessarily want to or you're afraid to sometimes,
exactly.
right? sometimes you brave something when you're a little afraid to do it, too.
Right.
You know?
But oftentimes, you know, when if you do brave something, like in our normal lives, we find out that it's really not as bad as we thought it was or built it up to be in our minds. So we do need to learn to take risks and to do some things that maybe we wouldn't normally do. And she is very happy, Mandy is very happy that she has, because she says here that she's learned a lot about her grandparents' relationship as a result. Because when you're out walking together at 5 a.m., you know, what do you do? I'm sure they're not walking in silence.
No. Yeah, no, and okay. They just know the fact that they enjoy being together and they can look at things. And there's something about it that she's just learned, the relationship that the family has, that they like to be together. And it kind of, I would say, binds them together, doesn't it?
Right. And, you know, we're talking about two generations here. So her grandmother's lifestyle was totally different at her age that the granddaughter is now.
Right.
So it's given her an opportunity to learn about what her grandmother's life was like in when she was growing up, and also her grandmother and grandfather's relationship in their family and how their family was built, probably how they met and, you know, how they their life as they were, you know, starting a family and beginning life together.
Right, which I'm sure had many good stories to hear.
I'm sure they did, right.
Well, if we're talking about this, you know, if we're talking about this year, you know, 2016 and 2017, then her grandmother, this would have been happening like in the 1920s and 30s. So
Correct.
If you think back about that, that's a long time ago, or 1940s probably.
40s. That would be my grandmother's time. Okay. But one of the 10 great-grandchildren joined this family. They call them a mobile family gathering. Now, we think of mobile, we think of mobile phones, but where's a mobile family?
It just means to move.
Move.
So, you know, like automobile, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So
that's right.
It's when they're talking about the mobile family gathering here, it means that they're walking or moving.
Right. Doesn't mean they're watching their cell phones.
No.
No.
Yeah, usually family gatherings, like maybe a Thanksgiving dinner, you sit down and eat dinner, but here they're moving.
Yes.
They're and they talk dinner. About their family history and everything. And so she just continues to do this, but now she's doing shorter races, right?
Well, I think she's allowed to.
I can't guess so by now. Let's read the rest of the article.
A true inspiration. For the past several years, Joy has written her age followed by "Come Walk With Me" on the back of her shirt. She has stories from races past of younger men and women taking her up on the offer. "I hope I'm doing this when I'm your age," she's often been told. Distance races have taken Joy all over the country, and more than 100 medals, many she received for finishing first in her age group, hang on walls inside her home. Race day! On Sunday morning, Joy and Dean were up before 5. Family members in the race wore orange shirts that read, "Team Joy, Walk of Ages." At 7:45 a.m., contestant number 17847 stood among a gaggle of runners, inching closer to the start line. "Oh my gosh, it's Dorothy Joy!" an MC bellowed. 90 years young. Make some noise for Dorothy Joy!" The crowd roared. And with that, Joy was off.
So we see here that she has been doing this, you know, for several years. And what she has written on the back of her shirt, actually, she's worn this shirt for a long time that says, "Come Walk With Me." And people actually do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I thought that was kind of cool.
It's an invitation for people, you know, to come and also get involved and to do some physical activity.
Mm-hmm. I think that maybe people that are on the edge thinking about it, you know, I mean, you know, you've met people that would that have said, I'd like to try that, or mm-hmm. I should do something more.
And there's that lady doing it, let's yeah. go walk with her.
And she's yeah, 90 and years old.
Yeah. 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 So, you know, what is your excuse?
Exactly.
Yeah. So I think that she
I think
is
you have to sign up on those ahead of time, don't you? Don't you have to sign up for those?
Who's well, for you marathons, yeah. but I'm yeah. sure she's out. She doesn't just walk during a marathon.
No,
she's
that's
probably
true.
Out, you right. know. Practice, like, right. we don't practice walking, but you know.
Well, that's I mean, you might, you know, just out.
Exercising.
About, I'm sure yeah. she wears that shirt, and it also inspires people to maybe also do this.
Well, I guess so, because she could probably tell you more about it. It says that she has stories from all these races in the past mm-hmm. of younger men and women taking her up on the offer, saying, okay, you said so, I'm going to go with you.
Right.
So they take her up on it. That's a good phrase.
Right. This if you take somebody up on something, it means that you accept it. So if somebody offers you, I don't know, a position, maybe at a job, or they offer you, I don't know.
Something.
Yeah, something. They ask you out to dinner, and you take them up on their offer or offer you
accept.
A, mm-hmm. Yeah, it just means to accept something.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a very good phrase to use.
Right. And what do people often say to her?
I hope I'm doing this when I'm your age.
Mm-hmm.
And Doris, I think people say that to you all the time.
To blame the trumpet when I'm your age, right?
That's right.
Whatever you do, just keep on doing it. That's what I always say. Don't stop.
Right.
Yeah. Go forward, right? But the distance races, though, they've taken her all over the country, not just in Huntington Beach, but she's had so many medals because she finished first in her age group. I don't know how many more people are in her age group. Can't be very many, but, you know. But these, where are all these medals? They hang on the walls inside her home, so her home is covered with all these medals.
Yeah, 100. That's a lot of medals.
Mm. This really is. Right.
But and she should be proud of it.
Yes, yeah, she should.
Yeah. I think it's interesting also that she travels to do this as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she's not just, you know, going down the street. It takes some effort for her to actually get to some of these races.
Well, yeah. probably they want to use her for advertising. Come and
true.
Join this 90-year-old lady.
True.
See if you can beat her.
Yes, see if you can beat her, right. Yeah. Well, what happens actually on race day?
Well, here it is. This race happens to be on Sunday morning, and they're up before 5.
And all the grandchildren don't like that. Right?
Well, that in and of itself is an accomplishment to
yes,
get up before 5.
For kids.
And in this particular race, they wore orange shirts that read, Team Joy, Walk of Ages.
That's pretty interesting.
That is very cute. And you see that on the back of her shirt at the bottom, right below this paragraph, if you have your magazine, it says, Mom, I'm 90.
Yes, and that's something, yeah.
So you see that they're beginning like way before sunrise.
Mm-hmm.
And then the race is beginning around 7:45 a.m. So probably while the air is still a little bit cool.
Well, you know, Linda, I was wondering, why did they call this a gaggle of runners? I thought it was a gaggle of geese when they go walking. A gaggle is a group
right.
name.
It's a count word for a
but
gathering.
Do you do that for runners? I didn't know runners were gaggle. Don't you think
maybe
that's
they look like geese when they run.
I
was very surprised at this.
Imagine, geese, they're not quiet. So if you have a group of runners all ready for the race, they're you know,
honking.
They're excited, yeah, and they're maybe a little noisy and ready for the race.
Yeah, I think they just threw that word in there. I'm not sure that a group of runners would be called a gaggle particularly, but people might wonder about that, right?
Yeah. But so usually if you hear this word, it's not a very common measure
no.
word because we usually mm-hmm. say a gaggle
it's
of
a
geese,
measurement.
Right?
Right. That's
but
true.
Yeah, I think, yeah, I learned something in this article.
Well, you could say that, but she says, oh my gosh, it's Dorothy Joy. Just means, oh my goodness. Here she is. The MC bellowed out. She hollered it out. There she is. And everybody's quite excited, aren't they?
Right. And an MC is a master of ceremonies. So you can see, if you think of the word master of ceremonies, sometimes if you get a program, you'll see the capital M, capital C.
Yeah, master of ceremonies. Right.
Right. But when you spell it out, they actually spell it E-M-C-E-E.
Right.
And bellowed. We have two words in these last few lines here. One is bellowed and one is roared.
Mm-hmm.
So if you bellow something, what are you doing? It has a different sound than a roar.
about the same,
it's
isn't
a
it?
Low, loud voice.
Right.
But it
we
also
usually think
be...
of like cows. Right. You know, cows if are bellowing.
Mm-hmm.
But a roar, what is the difference between that? We don't, you know, we use roar often. If you're listening to ocean waves and they're really loud, we say the waves were roaring.
I think of motorcycles at night roaring down the street.
But they don't bellow.
No, but they roar.
Right. But I'm just trying to,
it's a loud
to show
noise.
The difference.
Yeah.
Yeah, roaring is just a really loud noise, and there were so many people there
mm-hmm.
that they were cheering her on.
Right.
And when they say, make some noise for Dorothy Joy, it means to cheer her
yes.
on.
Right. Yay. And they do. And the joy was off. Well, that's sort of an interesting, encouraging story. And to review it today, the main point of this is that she is not giving up. And Tapu Fang, she still keep going, doing what she does. She might slow down a little. Mm-hmm. You can change the way you do it, but you don't have to stop doing things just because you say, now I'm too old for that.
Right.
Don't ever say that.
Yeah.
Don't you
right.
ever
you
say
can
that.
See that she actually is not running now. She's walking.
Right.
You know?
Right.
But she's still walking, and she's still doing it. And I think, you know, she has an interest in life, and I think for all of us, we need to keep that in our lives.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't allow age to be a limitation.
Right.
I mean, you might have to adjust the intensity, but still keep doing what you enjoy.
So if I say to Linda, I'd like you to come out and go scuba diving, you can take me up on the offer.
Exactly.
What about
okay,
that?
Okay.
Okay, see?
I'm there.
That's the way. Okay, well, it's been fun talking about that. And, you know, you can make your lifestyle more exciting if you accept new challenges. So even in studying and reading and learning, mm-hmm. not just in activities like mm-hmm. that, in the kind of things that you are still learning, don't you think?
Yeah, I totally agree. Be a curious person.
And you'd be surprised how many people in their 90s are still listening to Advance. So keep on. And when you're 15 years old, you can listen too. Right?
That's right.
We'll come back tomorrow for another lesson, and thank you for being with us today. So let's just keep on. Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye.
Bye.